Hi, my name is Matthew from Genesis Mobile Entertainment. We own a entertainment company, and once a year we run a Heart Foundation and an ANZ Fontan Registry charity event. The name of the event is called Heartbeats, and it's been put together by myself, Matthew, from Genesis Entertainment. Now, I'd like to tell you a little bit of background information about the Heartbeats charity event and how it all started. On the 12th of May 1983, I was born with a very rare congenital heart disease, which was giving me heart failure as a baby. As they found out, 3-4 days later, by the 6th day of me being born, I had to do a heart surgery, which unfortunately was not successful. And then 2 weeks later, I did another heart operation, open heart, and they were managed to successfully, I suppose, bandage my heart for another 3 years. That was successful enough for me to grow into a 3-year-old, and then I was probably nearly four when I had my last operation. Now, that was called a Fontan, where that was extremely successful, and they managed to sort out the problem and rectify it for the time being. Since then, I had a normal childhood. I tried to play sport, however I did used to get puffed out, tired, but I still tried to push myself and have a natural, normal childhood. I found my passion for music very early in life. I think I was like 4 or 5 years old when I started to sing to Elvis and rock and roll, Michael Jackson, and into all this type of music. That pretty much continued through till I was 18, where I left school and then began my business. However, when I was 16, I went on school camp, and from the time that I was 3 years old and had the operation to the time that I was 16, I didn't have any real issues until I turned 16 and I went on camp. Which I remember my mother was saying, "Why do you want to go on camp? You're going to be outside in the cold, this, that." And I said, "Ma, I want to go. All my mates are going, as you do." Probably should have listened to mum, because mum's always right. But I didn't, and I went on to camp, and we got a little bit wet, and I did get very sick. But I assumed it was just a flu or a cold. But when I arrived back home, my heart was palpitating very fast in a rapid rhythm. And it was doing that for a good 2 weeks before I said to mum, "Hey, I think something's wrong." So then we did a few tests, went to doctors. They said, "Yes, your heart is in rapid rhythm. It's palpitating very fast and it shouldn't be going that fast." So I was only supposed to go into hospital for just a normal procedure. What they were going to do is put me to sleep and shock my heart back into rhythm. And I do remember going in on the Tuesday, but unfortunately they did the procedure, it all worked out fine, but I had an allergic reaction to some medication that was given. And unfortunately, that I remember actually going to the bathroom, and that's all I remember. I actually collapsed and had a heart attack, went into cardiac arrest, and I remember waking up the week after on the Wednesday. So I went in on the Tuesday the week before and then woke up on the Wednesday thinking it's just the Wednesday and it was all fine. I was only supposed to go in for a day, but little did I know I was in there for a week. But I had friends and family there supporting me and there for me. And, when I woke up and came to, they were all quite emotional and crying and all type thing. And I just thought nothing was wrong. I just thought it was the next day and I'm ready to go home. But yeah, then when they told me that you were, you know, in a coma or so for a week, and you know, then I realized, well, that's massive. I couldn't really comprehend it really at the start. But then unfortunately, as obviously I got a bit better and I started taking different medication to help with that. But then after that occurrence when I was 16, it started to happen a little bit more often. So then it would happen once every 3 years or 2 years, and I'd just get these palpitations happening. So I'd have to go into hospital and they'd have to shock me and then I'd be on my way home. So in between all that, I was trying to build my business, Genesis Mobile Entertainment, where I did have a passion for, you know, music and entertaining people. That's what I love to do. So I actually entered a competition for, I suppose, an Elvis impersonators competition, and I did quite well, and I came third out of a whole heap of impersonators in Australia. And it wasn't until then that, you know, one of the judges said, you know, you've done a really good job, you should probably do it as a career. And I said, yeah, well, I've actually got an entertainment company, and I decided to add the shows to it. So we do 60th birthdays, 50th. I tour all the retirement villages and aged care facilities and perform Elvis now. And that's something that I love to do for the oldies. They simply enjoy the show. They love it. I love when I go there, and it's a really rewarding to do. But unfortunately, this palpitations kept occurring, and it happened to me one time during a show, which was pretty devastating for me. I did a show and I was doing Elvis, and right when I was doing, you know, Big Suspicious Minds with a lot of Elvis moves, it just felt it beating again. And then I finished up and went to hospital, they shocked it back, and then, you know, it kind of hit me then, like, Jesus, this is happening because I'm doing these shows, or I'm entertaining too much, or so. We had a number of doctor's appointments, and they told me, we don't think you should perform anymore. They said we think that could be making your heart beat fast, and then that your heart will just continue beating fast. So when they told me that, I was pretty distraught and devastated, because that's, you know, what I love to do. I love to interact with people. I love to sing, dance, and entertain. And that's my life. That's what I do. And to hear those words was really hard. But I stopped doing shows for a couple of years, and it happened again. And we realized that, maybe it wasn't from the Elvis shows, because I was just at home, you know, sitting on my couch watching a bit of TV. And I went back to the doctor. Obviously they shocked it back into rhythm and all was fine. But then this kept on occurring, this rapid rhythm, for, you know, quite some time, in a few years. And this Heartbeats charity event is something that I've wanted to do for a long, long time. Ever since I began the business, I knew that I wanted to build it up so I can run these, my own events, and give back to the Royal Children's Hospital, Heart Foundation, Fontaine Registry if I can. And that's why we started running these events. Now, I started these events probably 3 years ago. The first event, we had maybe 120 to 130 people. We raised, about $4,000. And then the second event, we raised, the second year, we did maybe about $3,500, something like that. So in total, we've probably raised about $7,000 for the Heart Foundation. This year, we are looking to absolutely smash that record. We can fit 500 to 600 people at this venue. So my goal is to possibly get 200 people there. That would be fantastic. But I can't do it on my own. I do need the support of the community, the support of businesses, local companies to hop on board. Whether it's with a donation to the raffle, or donation for an auction, or just a donation for everyone in the community to come to the event. The more people we have at the event, the more money we raise. Come along and, you know, tables of 8 or 10 we take. So, you know, if you wanted to come down with your business and make a table of 10, the more people that come, that's straight money going straight to the Heart Foundation and the Fontan Registry. So your support would be greatly appreciated. In return, we definitely are will promote the companies that help us out on the event day and leading up to it through social media, through other avenues as well. But we would really like to see businesses hopping on board, whether it's small or large businesses. Every little penny helps, and every also all the proceeds go straight to the Heart Foundation on the Fontan Registry. So everything we raise on the night, leading up to the night, raffles, auctions, is all going straight to the Heart Foundation and the Fontan Registry. We really appreciate it if you could come along, tell all your friends and family, all your co-workers and colleagues. If you'd like to come to this event, we only do it once a year. It's going to be on June the 27th, this year, 2015. We are selling tickets at the moment. Please contact me either by email or message or my contact number, which we'll put at the bottom of the screen here. Otherwise, it's 0414822474. Please contact us for tickets for this event. They are on sale as we speak. We're going to have a fantastic night that night. We will be having DJs, entertainment, tribute shows performed by Sean Spiteri, who is a leading Elvis impersonator in Australia. We'll also be having face painting, ballooning, heaps of stuff for the kids, so bring the family along. It's going to be a fantastic night with auctions, raffles, and great prizes to be won. Tickets are $75 per person. That will include buffet dinner and buffet dessert with complimentary beer, wine, and soft drink all night. And children are $25. So please contact us. We're trying to sell as many tickets as possible. Tell all your friends about it, and we hope you can come along to the next Heartbeats event.
Where is it?
Oh, yes. We should ask where it is. So, location of the venue, it will be at Taylor's Lakes Hotel. Just in Taylor's Lakes, you can't miss it. Next door to Jungle Mania, Kids Play Centre. So, Taylor's Lakes Hotel will be the venue. Hope that this year we can raise so much money at the Heartbeats charity event. I'm really pumped for this. I really want to interact with the people, meet new people. I also want to meet people from the Fontan Registry and people that have heart disease. We'd love to hear from you. Really want to hear your stories, not just mine. I'd like to hear your stories. We'd like you to come to this event and tell your story, even if you want to do a YouTube clip or email it to me. We can post it. We want to share it. We want to share everyone's stories so that everyone can hear about the Heart Foundation and people suffering from heart disease, because it's not just the individuals who suffer from it, it's also friends and family that suffer from it, from having these people in hospital for 3 months to 6 months, and it's really hard on families as well. So we really encourage families to come along, support this event, and we'll try our very best to help raise money. All the money that is raised is going to families that have children or have loved ones in hospital. It also goes to funds to give kids tablets and iPods and things like that, to help them through while they're recovering. It also goes to research, which is the major point where it goes to research. Finding a way to help something that maybe can't be cured. Obviously, when you're born with, heart defects and that, but the research is there so that they can help and find out, how to do better operations and less strenuous and operations. So please, donate and give us a call, and we hope to see you at this event. Thank you very much for listening to me today. It is greatly appreciated. We hope and we really urge you to tell all your friends and family, please share this this video with your friends and family or people or loved ones that you know are going through heart disease or heart problems. We definitely want to hear from you and we really hope that you come along to this event. I cannot stress it enough. It is for a fantastic cause and we really would like to urge everyone to make an effort, and if you're available that day, please come along. And don't forget, please share Heartbeat's page, which is important. We're trying to share it so that everybody can see the event and what we're doing and what we're trying to do for people. And also, you know, if you want to, you can either share it through Genesis Mobile Entertainment or you can also share it through Heartbeats and like our pages. Thank you very, very much for your time and listening to me. It is greatly appreciated and we hope to see you on the dance floor on June the 27th at the next Heartbeats charity event. Thank you for your time. Bye.